Hey, what's going on, YouTube? What's happening? So this is CC Talk yet again, coming through to talk about some casting news, and this time it's over General Hospital. For those of y'all that don't know and haven't been on your Facebook or your Twitter feeds today, Elizabeth Hendrickson is joining General Hospital under a new character. Yeah, because we don't have enough of those type of new characters. There's at least about 10 to 12 characters that should be fucking killed off of this damn bloated ass cast. Right, Frank? But I know you ain't gonna do it, so why am I even, you know, requesting that you should? You just go keep on adding more new characters every couple of months. You're not doing right by Tamara Braun, you're not doing right by Wes Ramsey, you're not doing right by James DePava, and, you know, all these new characters is a detriment to the show. Instead of you just going into the Bible and just made Elizabeth Hendrickson into a character from the show's Bible, or fuck it, like, you know, bringing on Serena Baldwin, bringing back Jenny Francis under contract and giving her great storylines considering the mistreatment you gave her. No, we're gonna bring on Elizabeth Hendrickson and give her a new character. And mind you, you know, I love Elizabeth Hendrickson. She's done great work at every soap she's ever been on, but no, I'm not confident that he gonna do right by her, because look what he has done with the, you know, like I said, with the people that I've already named off. Look what he did to Rebecca Budick, a wildly popular actress from All My Children, and he kicked her out quick as he got her. So I'm like, please, I don't trust this guy's management at all running this damn show. I would have loved if Elizabeth Hendrickson would have went to Days of Our Lives personally, because she could have played Chelsea Brady, because she's a dead ringer for, in a lot of ways, she looks like a wonderful cross between a Peter Ruckel and, you know, Lauren Coslow that could have played her grandmother on that show. And you could have played up the dynamics of Abigail and Chelsea being friends, because when Rachel Melvin and Ashley Benson from Pretty Little Liars were on that very show, their characters were BFFs, and you could have had, you know, Chelsea get at Chad's dick, you know, on that show, and then you could have had Kate being an instigator, being like, yeah, come on, Chelsea, go ahead and get with Chad, because you know Kate don't like Abigail like that. But that's the fault of Days. I wish my show was a little bit quicker to the punch with these sort of things, but they're not, and, you know, whatever. But, hey, like I said, I don't begrudge Elizabeth Hendrickson. If her and her agent said it's fine to go over there and get herself a check, and, you know, so she could pay her bills, put food on the table, and have some money for herself, hey, I'm not going to begrudge her. Who I'm looking at, like I said, at the end of the day, is Frank Valentini, because he's only doing this because he's at this, like, war with YNR. And it's like, what war are you trying to be at with YNR? YNR has been number one in the ratings ever since 1988, boo-boo. You are in no war with them. You know, yeah, you got Billy Miller and Michelle Stafford and now Elizabeth Hendrickson, but I'm like, you know, that's not gonna increase your numbers any further in the ratings, you know, and especially not with this tired ass writing you got going on with this show. So please, you know, but we all know what's about to happen, you know, considering the dynamics of the show right now. You know, Drew has asked Sam for a divorce. Sam is going to be pushed back over there with Jason, you know, and Drew is going to be in the wilderness. And I'm pretty sure within the coming months, you know, this new character, you know, that's going to be played by Elizabeth Hendrickson, is going to be potentially paired with Billy Miller's Drew, because y'all know when they both was on YNR, for those of y'all that watched during that time period, they did have really good chemistry together, and they were in good storylines together as well. So I'm not surprised that this is probably the route that they are possibly going to go with her, particularly Frankie, because like I said, he's at a war with YNR, which is a stupid war, because again, you know, if Guza couldn't beat YNR in the ratings, what makes you think that you're gonna beat YNR in the ratings once you do this pairing? It's just like, come on, bruh. Like, get your head out of your ass. Stop trying to have an ego as big as Napoleon. And do better by the cast that you have already on canvas. And, you know, write, you know, have your writers write better for them. She should love being inside those damn writing rooms and pitching your own ideas, you know? So whatever. Anyways, feel free to write, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think about this news, and I'll holla. Peace.